Hey, everybody. Welcome. Thank you guys for coming out tonight. We really appreciate everyone coming here, especially with the weather and traffic and all the like. Also, I move a lot when I talk and move my hands a lot. Bernard's like, oh, God. So picture this. You're at a bridal show. You've been in business for a couple years now, and you book a bride right on the spot. Destination wedding. You're over the moon. It's your first one. You're so excited. You finally made it. You've put all these years of time and effort and love into building this company, this creative type company that you guys give so much more to than you get back, right? It's truly a labor of love. And you book this couple right on the spot. You start planning. And you start to realize, you know what? This wasn't quite the best fit, but that's okay. That's okay. We're professionals. We can do it. We're going to power through this. And then you get to the wedding day, and you start to realize, uh-oh, the couple's gone a little bit rogue on us and didn't really heed all of our suggestions, but that's okay. We're gonna work through it. And then you're told 100 guests are going to show up, 200 show up, and you're starting to figure out, okay, how's the food going to work? How's this all going to come together? And one thing after another starts to go wrong. It starts raining. You don't have enough for transportation, all these different things, but you knock it out. Like you just keep nailing everything that comes at you. And so much so that you still get a 5-star review. So this actually happened to us. This is where the idea of Bustled was born. We're driving home from a wedding that my wife and co-founder Sammy was planning. And we started to quickly realize there needed to be more qualification of couples. And there needed to be more qualification of vendors as well. So that's why we've built Bustled. So I'm Ryan, one of the co-founders. I come from a data and technology background. I won't bore you guys with the details. It was the opposite of weddings, but that's okay, because we have Sammy. But I did a lot of work with Bank of America and SunTrust and Microsoft and LinkedIn. And that really helped inspire a lot of what we've done from a technological standpoint. I'll let Sammy introduce herself, because she's the real brains behind everything.
Hey everyone, I'm Sammy. Thank you guys again for coming. So like Ryan mentioned, a little bit of my background. I actually planned events in New York when we were living up there, different kinds of celebrity and corporate events, and it was obviously incredible learning experience. But I was wanting something a little more personal, and so that's how I found my way into weddings, started kind of trying weddings in New York, and really found that that was my passion. And then we wanted to move back down to the South.
Roll Tide.
Ryan had very generously followed me to New York City.
Sorry, Georgia fans.
Yeah, you're not supposed to talk about that here. and so moved back down to Charlotte and started my company. And so, you know, plan weddings still as well. We do about 30 to 35 weddings a year and have a ton of great insight into all the things that wedding vendors go through. And so that really kind of got us thinking of how can we better service other fellow wedding vendors. And that's how, like Ryan mentioned, the idea of Bustled really came to be. And so while we do a lot of different things, we have kind of three main priorities in our business. So the first is that we vet every vendor on our site. So this isn't, you know, everyone can be on. We personally talk to every single vendor on the site to make sure that, you know, they hit a few of our key metrics. We hear from brides all the time that they're worried that they're going to hire a vendor who can't deliver. And so we want to do our part to help them feel more confident. And then from the vendor side, we want you to feel really confident about the vendor whose, you know, name is showing up next to yours on our site. So we want you to be proud of that. The second thing we do is matching. So instead of paying to sit at the top, we have built a matching quiz. So it's a fun quiz that our couples go online and take when they sign up. And the vendors also take the same quiz. And then we take their results and your results, and we show them the best fit for their specific wedding day. So you're going to get more qualified leads, and they're going to be a better fit for you. So you're not just, you know, sending out endless emails to people who don't want to spend the money on your services or aren't a good fit. You know, they're looking for a barn, and you're this beautiful venue in the city. So those kinds of things. And the third thing is being hyper-local. So we wanted to set out and really build something that was local for both a local experience and a boutique experience for both our couples and our vendors. So in everything that we do, it's a super local approach. So from the real weddings we feature to the Instagram that we have, everything is local. So I'll let Ryan talk a little more about that.
So, and then just to kind of add on to that from the local side, we don't have a specific style. Obviously, quality is incredibly important, but we want to be hyper-local in what we feature. We want to showcase what Atlanta and the Atlanta area has to offer, right? So it doesn't have to be just bright and airy or dark and moody or everything in between, right? For us, it's really what does this area have to offer, and that's really what we want to focus on from a local standpoint. Also, I got a little nervous, and I forgot to kind of talk a little bit about the history. We started in Charlotte 3 years ago this month. So we've been at it for 3 years now, and this has been something that we've just organically built, and really it's truly is a grassroots movement as we try to kind of really change the industry and how couples find their vendors and their inspiration. So that being said, that all sounds great, but what do you actually do? So we really see ourselves as a marketing partner. So we kind of run the gambit. Obviously, websites are amazing, right? Couples go to them. They can look for real weddings and styled shoots, and they can look for vendors, and they can take the quiz, and all that is amazing. We also know that couples go to a lot of different channels and a lot of different avenues. So what we do is we make sure our vendors are showcased everywhere brides' attention is. I'm from Alabama, so you have to excuse the grammar. So website, and then we kind of segue into social. So we actually feature our vendors through our local Instagram. That's a big piece of what we do. 87% of couples use Instagram as part of their journey. So we want to make sure that our vendors are there, and they're being showcased through our local account. We actually manage 9 different accounts, which is bananas. From there, we pin everything to Pinterest because 72% of couples use Pinterest. So we want to make sure your work is there. We actually just started a podcast. I'd encourage you guys to go check it out. It's called Everyday I'm Bustlin'. You'll have to excuse the sound in the first few because we didn't know what we were doing, but then we've really learned it. And then in the last five, six have gone, we're in a studio now. So we're big time.
We're moving up.
That's right. And we just do a lot of different things as well. Again, the idea is we want to help y'all get your brand out there so couples can discover you guys, right? There's thousands of vendors out there, so we really want to make sure that couples can find you and they can trust the vendors that are on our site. So that's really where we're coming from, and I'll let Sammy kind of close it out here.
Yeah, and like you said, we want the right couples to find the right vendor, and that's our goal. So we just wanted to thank all of you guys for coming tonight. We really appreciate it. We also wanted to say a huge thank you to all of our event partners, Ventanas for hosting us in this beautiful space, DJ Cuttlefish, Robot Booth, Grapefruit Photo, Lunacy Atlanta, Atlanta Pedal Peddler, Focus Films Atlanta, and the Frosted Pumpkin Gourmet. And we also wanted to give a big shout out to our team who pulled this whole event together, Lauren in the corner who planned everything and made this night possible, and Amanda and Christine, I know Amanda's there, who are our account directors and just, you know, amazing and can tell you all about our story. So thank you so much to our team and our event partners and you guys for coming. We really appreciate it. Enjoy the rest of the night.